Hello guys, a very good morning and welcome to the channel. It is just past 7 and we are on our way. Our destination are the forests of North Bengal, popularly known as Duars. We are currently approaching Bali Bridge or Vivekananda Bridge, which serves as the northern gateway in and out of Kolkata. Let me tell you a couple of interesting facts about this bridge. Out of the four bridges which connect Kolkata with Howrah, this is by far the oldest. It was commissioned in 1930 and has been in continuous use for 90 years. It is also the only bridge which has a railway line over it. And this line connects Kolkata with North Bengal. Today we are going to take NH2 or National Highway 2 towards Bardhaman and then take a right for Moorgram. As I live in the northern part of Kolkata, I use this bridge on almost every journey. It connects me to the two main highways leading out of Kolkata towards Mumbai and Delhi. Just after crossing the bridge, we come to a fork in the road. The left lane is heading towards Mumbai while the right one is going towards Delhi, and that is the one we will take towards Bardhaman today. After a couple of hours of uneventful riding on the highway and a quick tea break, we take a right towards Bardhaman city. This is the Badshahi road which will take us all the way to Moorgram and connect us to NH34 on our journey towards North Bengal. So guys, our original plan was to get to Bardhaman by 7 a.m. for which we needed to leave Kolkata by 5. But we left Kolkata at 7, so we are here at 9 a.m. and now we have to deal with the morning rush hour traffic. We are currently in the center of Bardhaman and let me show you something. On our left, we have the famous Curzon Gate. This is a very well-known landmark of Bardhaman. This rush hour traffic is killing us, but we don't have any choice but to deal with this for the time being. What the hell? That bicycle rider just put himself in a really, really bad spot. Now, whether you are a motorcyclist, you are on a bicycle, or you are a pedestrian, the last thing you should do is actually put yourself in between two buses. It's very risky. So currently we are on the newly constructed flyover over the Bardhaman railway station. And I can tell you right now, this has made a huge difference. The old bridge was narrow and took hours to cross. This is a huge improvement. And I also have to say that this is quite a beautiful flyover. It looks like a suspension bridge, and quite similar to the second Hooghly Bridge or Vidyasagar Setu back in the southern part of Kolkata. Now, we will take this bridge towards the state highway, towards Morgram. But we still have a lot of city traffic to navigate. So we will talk once we are outside the city. So finally, we are outside Bardhaman and we are on the Badshahi Road heading towards Morgram. I actually prefer to ride on these roads rather than highways, even though these are single lanes, because the landscape is so breathtaking. So just sit back and enjoy. So guys, we are actually running quite a bit late. This road is not as well maintained as it used to be. There is a lot of traffic, and additionally we have hundreds of speed breakers like this one. So all of these factors combined are slowing us down quite a bit, and it seems we may not be able to reach Raiganj before nightfall. Now that is a problem because my bike doesn't have any fog lights. I wasn't anticipating riding at night, and the headlight of this bike is actually quite weak, so it's not of much use on a highway. So it seems we have to focus on riding for the next few hours and try to get into Rayganj before it gets dark, otherwise it will be pretty dangerous. So I'll see you at Rayganj.
Hey guys, good morning from Kolkata. So the trip has actually ended and we are safely back. You must be wondering why I am not speaking to you from Rayganj. We'll get into that, but let's start from the beginning. So our original plan was to start from Kolkata at 5 a.m. However, it didn't really work out and for various reasons we got delayed. So we finally started at 7, which is almost 2 hours late. The first part of the ride from Kolkata to Bardhaman went fine. The highway was, you know, in good condition and we reached Bardhaman at around 9 a.m. However, because we were delayed by a couple of hours, we ran into rush hour traffic and it took us a while to get out of Bardhaman. But finally, we were out of the city and we were actually on the Badshahi Road and cruising towards Mogra. The road was just gorgeous, as you must have seen in the video already. However, about 30 or 40 kilometers into the ride, we realized that the road wasn't as well maintained as it used to be. It was full of potholes and there was a lot of traffic. And additionally, there were like hundreds of speed breakers all over. Now, I do understand speed breakers are essential for road safety. They prevent people from overspeeding. However, there were just too many of them. Like at one point we counted 12 of them one after the other, and some of them were so high that, you know, the bike would actually get hung up on the speed brake. Watch.
I honestly wonder, you know, if the bike, which has pretty good ground clearance, is getting hung up, then what happens to vehicles with lower ground clearance on the speed breakers? These are just, you know, accidents waiting to happen.
So, due to all these reasons, we realized that, you know, we may not be able to reach Rayganj before nightfall, which was really, really important for us because my bike didn't have any fog lights. And the headlight on the Yamaha FZS is not strong enough for highway driving. So we decided to focus on riding and just, you know, we tried to get to Rayganj as quickly as possible. So it took us about 4 hours to reach Mogram. So we reached there about 1 p.m. And then from Mogram to Rayganj, it took us another 5 hours. The last hour or so of the driving, we had to, you know, basically ride in pitch black, and it was very difficult because, as I said, the headlight wasn't working great. So I was planning to vlog once I got to Rayganj, but when I reached and I opened up my luggage, I realized that I had left the spare batteries and the charger for this camera that I'm using for vlogging right now back home. So that is what happens, you know, when you get delayed and then you rush things and then you forget stuff. Now, this is the only camera I had that has some decent zoom. So I needed this for wildlife photography, and we were heading to Duars, which is a forest with rich wildlife. So I decided to preserve the batteries and I didn't vlog for the rest of the way. And that is why I am talking to you now. However, the overall trip turned out pretty okay. You know, you will see many interesting things in the next few episodes. So do keep watching and let me know what you think. And I just want to, you know, make one point. This channel is all about you guys, because I was already on the trip. So the whole reason I'm creating the vlogs and uploading them on YouTube is so that others can enjoy it. So do watch them and do comment and let me know what else do you want to see. Like, is this what you want to see, or do you want to see something different? And I'll try my best to, you know, create the vlog in that way. And if you enjoyed it, like, share and subscribe to my channel. And also don't forget to press the bell icon so that you can get notifications of the future videos.